They undergo the largest migration on Earth every single day. They number in the quadrillions and can grow as big as a car, though most can't be seen with the naked eye. Being underwater and out of sight means we rarely give them their due. But that's about to change. Shrink down as we enter the ocean microworld and discover the strange, the beautiful, the indispensable plankton. Just what is plankton? Greek for wanderer, they're the plants and animals that drift through the largest habitat on Earth, the ocean. Plankton can be split into two main kinds. First, there's phytoplankton. These are algae and other plant-like single-celled organisms that are powered by the sun through photosynthesis. The world owes at least half the oxygen we breathe to phytoplankton. The second kind is zooplankton. These are the animals, and they come in almost every shape imaginable. Some plankton live their whole lives as floaters, drifting on the ocean currents. This transparent wiggler is a gossamer worm. Unlike their earthworm cousins, gossamer worms like living above ground, and they spend their whole lives swimming. Don't let their elegance fool you, though. These worms are fierce predators to avoid, a nightmare for these copepods. Other plankton only spend the first part of their life as plankton, before settling down to the seafloor. Like this squat lobster, it grows and sheds its skin through 6 larval stages before reaching its final form. It swims around until it's ready to say goodbye to the planktonic life and sink down to the seafloor for a more grounded adult life. Other animals do the opposite, starting life on the ocean bottom before becoming planktonic nomads as adults. When the conditions are right, moon jellyfish bloom to become thousands of individuals. Then, the male moon jellies release sperm from their gonads into the water to fertilize eggs carried by the females. Their offspring, very un-jellyfish-looking hairy potatoes called planulae, quickly settle to the bottom of the ocean, where they metamorphose and open up at one end to become a polyp. One by one, Ephyra, pulsing symmetrical clones, will bud off the polyp and swim up into the water column to rejoin their planktonic brethren, eventually taking on the familiar shape of an adult jellyfish. The watery world of phytoplankton and zooplankton is a daily drama, an ocean teeming with plants and animals, predators and their prey, life and death. It's the ocean like you've never seen it before. Dive into season 1 of Microworlds, Plankton.